Hello there and welcome to this week's Media News with me, Gareth O'Connor. I'm just going to kick things off. As some of you may be aware, TechCrunch. Big American tech conference was on a couple of weeks ago now. And this is an article I stumbled across over the weekend by a rather smart lady called Helen Jones, based out of San Francisco. She's an account director and advertising agency. And she's come up with three things that she took away from TechCrunch. One, being a founder does not mean being there from day one. No, it doesn't. Lots of people can implement change within the business. Companies have multiple founding moments, so it's the people who have impact at those moments who should really be considered founders. Again, those senior people in the industry, new people are coming along all the time who have got brilliant ideas, who create new founding moments for a company or a brand, even an agency. Usefulness is a terrific marketing tool. Yes, it is. So much marketing is completely useless, but usefulness is always a winner. Think about what the need is. Most of you may probably already know this. And then create a direct response to that need. Kind of simple, right? Kind of that's where all the successes are coming from at the moment, particularly in the tech space. Tech plus purpose makes a fruitful union. Quite often, or very often, I hear clients talking about, let's make an app, let's do something in tech. Technology has to have a purpose. It has to be mission-driven. It has to be useful. It has to have the power to bring excellence to scale. Tech plus purpose, fruitful union. Remember that. The rise of Flipboard. Many people now are using Flipboards. Kind of social magazine, connect with people you like, obviously connect with content you like, and it's all curated for you in a lovely iPad-style magazine. I use it myself, it's kind of cool. But it's now 20 million people worldwide using Flipboard and sharing 3 million pieces of content every single, 3 billion, sorry, pieces of content every month. It is on the rise, good people, it's on the rise. I guess shared articles, it's a range of things really, but I mean, it's obviously whatever people are interested in, be it news, be it events, cultural, music, film. Anything across the web can be curated into your Flipboard. The UK are leading the charge, obviously, in this, but it is starting to expand, and people in APAC are using it too. And brands are starting to use it too. Here's Levi's. They're on there. It's kind of a nice idea. They're kind of curating everything that matters to the brand, matters to their people. But it's kind of cool. It's a good. So if you do have time, go and check it out. If you don't have it, it's worth checking out at least. Speaking of user numbers, Google. This is probably the first time they've officially actually released numbers, but they have 400 million users worldwide now, and around 100 million monthly active users. So pretty cool. A hybrid car. Peugeot have just launched a new hybrid car with four modes, you know, like sport, city drive, that sort of thing. But they've done it using a graphic novel. Obviously, it's not just a graphic novel. They've got other stuff going on. But they're using a graphic novel. Kind of a new approach, different approach. Will it work? I'm not sure. But in a way, kind of interesting. Follows the life of, I guess she's a spy. But it can go through there and you can watch. But, you know, kind of cool, a different way to try and engage people. But it goes through, obviously, the four modes of the car, the four modes of the four sections, four stages of the story. But there's a URL if you want to go and have a look. Kind of interesting. A fashion show event for a few, enjoyed by millions. This is kind of cool. Topshop have come a very long way. They were a brand that was cheap, but of course, now they're a brand that is very stylish, got great buyers, great style, all for an affordable price. But this is something they did at London Fashion Week, where they had a personalized, shoppable live stream experience that went as the fashion show was actually happening. Over 2 million people in 200 countries watched this, and it was all customizable. That you could click and buy directly from the video, and you could share stuff with your friends. It was a huge undertaking because they had, you know, running in their stores. They partnered with over 200 media partners online. Huge undertaking, but hats off to them. Really amazing. Now here's a little video. Give you a taste.
Yeah.
Very cool. Well done. A sign of the times. That flag there, you're probably wondering, what is that flag? It's Estonia, good people. Estonia, the birthplace of Skype. They're going to start teaching French graders French. No, they're not first graders French, are they? They're not. No, they're not really. They're going to start teaching code. Quite something, huh? Sign of the times. Preschoolers are also surrounded by tech. My son, who's three, can control my iPad and my iPhone. He can move around, he can buy stuff, do everything. But 81% now, slight rise, but look, you can see it's starting to see the rise of, you know, tablets, smartphones, laptops, computer-enabled TVs, all those sorts of products. Tech is obviously, you know, we were, us, you know, 30-somethings. We've grown with it, but these people are going to be growing into it. So it's kind of amazing. But it's a time to spend and all this time. You can obviously stop this to look at all these stats if you wish to. But the kind of thing is 21% of preschoolers now play games on mobile devices. It's a fifth. It's pretty high, considering last year it would have been, you know, 5%. 25% of preschoolers are now watching videos online. It's kind of amazing, but the growth is pretty significant. And another for you, smartphones will influence retail stores worth over $15 billion across the UK this year. I presented a while ago at a retail conference, and I spoke about how mobile was going to change retail, and people who spoke after me were kind of like, thought I was a bit delusional. But really, mobile is going to change the face of retail. They think, I mean, it's only 6%, but they think that 6% currently, in the next 4 years, that's going to increase to 15 to 18%. 2016 will come before you know it. That's between £35 and £43 billion worth of retail sales will be done from a mobile telephone by 2016. In America, it's a similar sort of picture. 5% now. In 2016, it'll be 17 to 21%. It's over nearly $782 billion worth of retail will be done through mobile. Again, we can help with mobile. If you're not thinking about it, start thinking about it, please. Apple launched ISO 6 update last week. It was highest adoption rate in update history. 17% of all iOS devices updated within 24 hours. Quite amazing. The only problem so far, I guess, here in NZ, it's not so bad. Maps are quite good here. But around the world, there's obviously a lot of maps problems because we've got rid of Google now using their own. Apparently, around the world, it's pretty poor. There are some pretty bad images online if you want to go and have a look. But here, it's not quite so bad. Interesting fact for you. And this is a good demonstration of the power of crowdsourcing for me. Crowdsourcing site Quirky produced 15 new iPhone accessories in 7 days. And that's like produced from concept to building to selling. As soon as the new specs for the iPhone 5 were launched, people started, you know, submitting their ideas. In 24 hours, a community of 240,000 people, which is big, pitched nearly 2,000 new products. And of course, they made 15 of them in 7 days. Kind of amazing how quick to market things can happen. In an attempt to make money, Facebook are now about to get into real-time bidding for ad space, which will be pitting advertisers against one another so you can bid for ad space. You can obviously follow how people are using not just Facebook, but the web in general, and you can fight for those individuals. Kind of, I guess, in the same sort of way that Google, the content network and display network works. The new system will be called Facebook Ad Exchange, or FBX. AdRoll, which is one of the companies who have been testing it, have said of their 60 clients, they generate an average of $16 return on every dollar spent, which is quite amazing, if that is indeed true, but that's what they say, it's a pretty good return. This is kind of a nice ad, and a very good use of Facebook integration for World Alzheimer's Day. Probably one of the worst diseases to get. Oh, it would just be a nightmare. Oh. But this is a really nice way of just spreading awareness of the disease on Alzheimer's Disease International Day. And basically what it was, you just donated your Facebook timeline and it would start to make your Facebook timeline disappear, your friends disappear. Very much like the disease, of course. A good use of Pinterest, yes. Obviously some brands are getting to Pinterest. It's a kind of a good thing, I guess, for brands to show what it means to them. Of course, charities are doing a lot of this. But this is a nice thing from Pinterest for UNICEF, just talking about what Africans really want. I really want these, and just go through a list. Really nice idea, and a good use of a brand or charity using Pinterest. Hot Wheels are at it again. I'll just show you a bit of this. But again, kids game. Make real content. Do it for real. Engaging content works, you know. People will watch it. Good way of spreading your brand, spreading your brand's story. Woohoo! I remember my cars doing that when I was a little kid. Yeah, it's pretty cool. You can watch more of it if you go online. A different way, this is a nice actually opportunity, a way of delivering on donations and the importance of donations. Kind of a nice idea using a magnetic billboard. Picture of a man clubbing a seal. Use your money to cover up the man. And then of course when you turn the magnets off, you can take all the money and you've got yourself donations. Kind of a nice idea. There you go, you can see that. New iPhone, yep, equals a new app from Samsung. Guess it had to happen, right?
Should have a priority line for people who've waited five times.
I heard you have to have an adapter to use the dock on the new one.
Yeah, but they make the coolest adapters.
Welcome back.
Guess that Galaxy S3 didn't work out.
No, I love the GS3. It's extremely awesome. I'm just saving a spot in line for someone.
That's not cool.
Yeah, man.
This year, we're finally getting everything that we didn't get last year.
Yeah.
The big screen.
True 4G.
Yep.
What is that?
Hey, what'd you just do?
Oh, I just did it on a playlist.
Like touching phones?
Yeah. Simple as that.
It's the Galaxy S3.
Yeah. Hey!
Hey, Mom, Dad.
Oh, thanks for holding our spot.
Hey, man.
Oh, hey.
How's it going?
Saved you a spot.
I moved on.
But you're not gonna miss all this?
I got the Samsung GS3 now.
Is that a Samsung?
That's a new Samsung. It is.
It's pretty cool.
But I kinda like it.
This one's 4G.
Yeah, we've had that for a while.
This one's got a big screen.
This one has a bigger one. And we can share videos instantly. You can watch a video while you're sending an email.
But we're gonna get that, for sure. Maybe not this time, but the next time, right?
The next big thing is already here.
Okay, it's good to always have a little jib at a competition if you can. And that's it from me this week. I will see you next week.